Welcome to Azure Essentials. In the next few minutes, we'll explore the defense-in-depth design of Azure services and capabilities to help you secure, manage, and monitor your cloud data and infrastructure. As a managed service, Microsoft designs and operates its cloud services with security at the core and provides you built-in controls and tools to meet your security needs. In addition, with machine learning and Microsoft's significant investments in cyber defense, you can benefit from unique intelligence and proactive measures to protect you from threats. Azure offers unified security management and advanced threat protection for your resources, whether they're in the cloud or your data center or both. Services in Azure are built with security in mind from the ground up to host your infrastructure, apps, and data. All services are designed and operated to support multiple layers of defense, spanning your data, apps, virtual machines, network, perimeter, related policies, and of course, physical security within our data centers. This includes how the data centers and systems that run Azure are architected and operated to the controls you can leverage as part of your defense-in-depth security management. Everything starts with identity and access control. All Azure resources we'll mention are governed by Azure Active Directory. You can learn more about this topic on Azure Essentials. Next, one of the most important built-in services to get familiar with is the Azure Security Center. Across Azure services, it provides unified visibility and control, adaptive threat protection, as well as intelligent threat detection and response. This gives you centralized and real-time monitoring into the security state of your Azure workloads with actionable recommendations and controls. Let's start with data, which is what you'll want to protect the most and is often the core of your apps and services. Data protections are built for both structured and unstructured data. For structured data, all data is encrypted at rest, and machine learning can be used to proactively look for and alert you on potential security vulnerabilities. These can be related to data encryption, enabling security telemetry, and extend to capabilities in data services themselves to recommend and enable sensitive information discovery and classification, dynamic data masks to obscure data fields, and more. Database services in Azure can be configured to run these checks automatically, and Azure Security Center will alert you on any potential issues it finds to keep your data protected. For unstructured data, storage accounts spanning blobs, files, tables, and queues are also encrypted at rest by default, and each account is geo-redundant. You can also apply further protections using access keys to control authentication, shared access signatures for secure delegated access, and granular network firewall controls. Azure Security Center will report its findings when security is at risk or protections have been disabled by an admin. Now, apps are the front end for accessing and presenting data, and their security is generally governed through data, VMs, or compute and platform services in Azure. Your web apps can be configured to use Azure Managed Service Identities to streamline secure communication with other services connected to Azure AD. You can manage SSL certificates for your apps and even require that clients connecting to your apps have valid certificates for inbound requests. Now, as you move into VMs and compute, the Azure Security Center uses machine learning to continuously assess security and vulnerability levels of your VMs, networks, and service configurations. It also gives you actionable recommendations to prevent exploits before they occur, and dynamically applies both allow and block lists to keep out unwanted traffic. As your hub for visibility and control, one thing to note is that many of these capabilities we give you also extend to your VMs in other clouds and in your data center. You can also benefit from intelligent threat detection and response. The Security Center leverages the Microsoft Intelligent Security Graph to discover and take action against attacks. The graph combines the cyber intelligence Microsoft collects across all of its services and industry data to block known attack patterns. We also give you the controls you need to prioritize alerts and incidents that are important to you. In addition, we give you a unified view for forensics analysis and the ability to search across all of your compute resources. You can even visualize threat intelligence down to the trending attack techniques and the geographic regions affected. For network security, the Azure Security Center will assess and report on potential network insecurity issues related to open ports and firewall settings and network security groups. Azure provides additional security when designing and architecting your apps to enforce logical network boundaries and limit permissions to network security groups. You can also control network and other resources like VMs with just-in-time controls for opening management and internet ports, with intelligent recommendations to reduce exposure to brute force attacks. Beyond your network controls, for perimeter security, Azure's DDoS protection, for protection against distributed denial of service attacks, is available at a basic level by default. Azure's DDoS protection standard version adds additional protection and mitigations against volumetric attacks, where the attacker's goal is to flood the network with traffic in efforts to disable your services. protocol attacks, where the attacker tries to find and exploit weaknesses in layer 3 and layer 4 protocol stacks, and application layer attacks, where the web application packets are used to disrupt transmission of data between hosts, like cross-site scripting or HTTP protocol violations. For security policies and access management, Azure has a comprehensive set of services to securely manage security policies and access to resources, whether accessed by people or programmatically via your code. These controls are more than just the front door to who or which processes can access your apps, files, or data, and extend to how granular access is delegated to your IT and development teams, using role-based access controls to ensure your team members only have access to what they need. Again, for more information, check out the Azure Essentials on Identity and Access Management. To automate the response to specific security events, you can also use a security playbook. Powered by Logic Apps, which is used in Azure to automate workflows, this orchestrates the set of actions that need to happen when a predefined event is detected by the Azure Security Center. Now, as I mentioned earlier, beyond the policies that you can set, security is infused in everything we do as we develop Azure services, from the planning and design phase all the way to development and delivery using the secure development lifecycle process. Fabric admins operate Azure services with zero standing privilege and use just-in-time approval processes to gain temporary access to sensitive data or controls when needed. Azure services comply with both international and industry-specific compliance standards and are subject to rigorous third-party audits that verify Azure security controls, so you've got peace of mind, especially in answering regulatory requirements such as GDPR. Finally, we extend our layered approach to physical security. Data centers managed by Microsoft have extensive layers of protection: access approval at the facility's perimeter, the building's perimeter, inside the building, and on the data center floor. This layered approach reduces the risk of unauthorized users gaining physical access to data and the data center resources. So that was a quick run through of the primary defense and security considerations in Azure at every defense in depth layer. These controls are all part of the shared responsibility model in Azure, comprising the security Microsoft manages as the service provider, built-in controls for you to protect your data and infrastructure, and the intelligence Microsoft can provide you from its global scale cyber defense operations. You can continue your learning at the link shown, and thanks for watching.